Hello students, today I am taking up this session for giving you the solutions and answers of the CCT practice assessment 5th, which was held recently on 27th, that is Monday. Now this exam was conducted for classes 7th to 10th uniformly, and among that we had 10 questions of mathematical literacy. Question number 1 to 10 were for English literacy, question number 11 to 20 for mathematical literacy, and 21 to 30 were for scientific literacy. Out of that, the mathematical portion, that is question number 11 to question number 20, these 10 questions, I will give you the solutions and the answers in my this video lecture. So here it is. So let's take up, this is the CCT practice assessment 5 for class 7 to 10th mathematical literacy. Now first was the question number 11 I have taken up. It was about equable shapes. The meaning of equable shapes was given that numerically the perimeter should be equal to area. That is, the value should be equal. As units cannot be equal, so only the value, if it is equal, then the shape is called equable shape. In this, two figures were given. In figure 1, there was a rectangle with sides 3.6 and 4.5. Let us first do the calculations for that. The area of rectangle comes out to be length into breadth. So 3.6 into 4.5 comes out to be 16.20, or we can write it as 16.2 square centimeter. Perimeter 2 into length plus breadth, that also comes to be 16.2. So the numerical values are equal. So this rectangle is an equable shape. Now let us check the second figure. In the second figure, the area can be easily taken out by half into base into height. So that comes out to be 12. Now for finding out the perimeter, we observe that it was given that this is a right angle triangle. So this is a perpendicular and this we can take as base. So by Pythagoras theorem, this will come as 5. You know, remember the Pythagorean triplet 3, 4, 5. So this side will be 5 and this side will also be 5. Because the base is again 3 and this is 4. So the three sides of this triangle become 5, 5 and 6. Thus its perimeter will be 16. Thus here the area is not equal to perimeter. So the correct answer for question number 11 would be figure A only is equable figure. Now we come to question number 12. In question number 12 it is asked that if it is given that this rectangle is an equable shape, then find y. So we'll have to put the area to be equal to perimeter. That means we have to put area will be 10y should be equal to 2 into 10 plus y. So this becomes a simple equation which we can solve. So this comes out to be, when we put area is equal to perimeter, it becomes a simple equation. We will solve it and we get y is equal to 5 by 2, which is equal to 2.5 centimeters. So the option C is correct for question number 2. Thus, we come to the question number 13, unit 3, parcel by courier. In this question, it is given that cost of parcel is 3.25 z and there is a fixed service charge which is 5 z's. Thus, we see that courier charge is to be taken as C. So, the courier charge C will be equal to 3.25 z's is for 1 kg and total it is W kg. So, it will be 3.25 W multiplied, and the fixed service charge is always there, plus 5 z's. So this should be the courier charge. Thus option B, which is given as C equal to 5 plus 3.25 W, is the correct answer. Now we come to question number 14. So question 14 says that Shelja has paid 57 z, so find the weight of her parcel. So let the weight be W, then according to this above relation, it will be 5 plus 3.25 W is equal to 57 z. So we will solve it. 3.25 W is equal to 57 minus 5. So by calculation, W will be equal to 16 kg. So now we come to the next unit 4, entertainment fair. In question number 16 says that Malvika has won every game that she has played, and number of cards of each type she will have with her when she comes out from the third stall are. So let's look at the rules. The rules is first that when you buy one gold card, you have to pay 20 zets, and when you buy one silver card, you have to pay 10 zets. So in all 30 zets. Malvika paid 30 zets and bought one gold and one silver. This is the refund values. Now in the first stall, she paid with one gold and one silver and she won both the games. So for one gold, she got the gold card back plus reward of one silver. When she played with one silver card, she got one gold instead, but silver was not returned. Thus, at the end of her play, her game at the first stall, what she had is two gold and one silver. Now, when she goes to the second stall, then she will play with the two golds and one silver. So, when she plays with her gold, her gold is returned to her and one silver is given back. So, one gold plus one silver. Here also she will get one gold plus one silver. And here she will get one gold as a reward. So, in all she will have three gold and two silver. Now, when she goes to third stall, there since she has in all five cards, she will play five games. Three with gold and two with silver. When she plays with gold, she will get one gold, one silver. One gold, one silver. One gold plus one silver. And in place of silver, she will get one gold each. So total she has five golds and three silvers. Thus, option A is correct. Five golds, three silver. Next, in question number 17, if she goes to the fourth stall and wins all the games there also, then how much money she will get as refund? She has played now at fourth stall, she will play with five golds and three silvers. So five golds she plays, so she will get back five golds and five silvers. And three silvers, she will get three golds for that. So total eight golds and five silvers she has. Now this eight golds will fetch her 18 zeds. And this five silvers will fetch her 8 zeds. So it will be 144 plus 40. That will be 184 zeds. This she gets after she has won all her games at the fourth stall. Thus option C is correct, 184 zeds. Question number 15. The weight of chess set is, let it be WKG. Then the weight of the photo frame will be W plus 4 kg. Thus, how much Cherian has to pay? Cherian will have to pay will be 5 plus 3.25 W, and what Iqbal has to pay will be equal to 5 plus 3.25 W plus 4. So this we will solve. So this gets multiplied 3.25 into W plus this will multiply and we'll get 13.00. So this becomes 18 plus 3.25 W. So now the difference between what Cherian pays and what Iqbal pays, the difference we can see that this and this will get cancelled when you subtract them.
18 plus 3.25w minus 5 minus 3.25w. So this gets cancelled and 18 minus 5 will be equal to 13z. So this will be the answer, 13z. Let's do the question number 18. Now we are here, we have the option of 3 formal shirts and 4 denim shirts. So for 3 shirts we have options of 4 pants each. So total there will be 12 options, right? Now when we select denim shirts, there are 4 types of shirts, and for each shirt again there are 4 options of pants, so 16 options. In all there will be 28 options. So answer to question number 18 will be part D, 28. Now let's come to question number 19. So in question number 19, since we have to take only the formal shirt and any and since it is with a formal shirt, only formal pants to be taken, so there are only 2 options for pants also. 3 options for shirts and 2 options for pants, so that will be total 8 options available. Thus, 6 plus 8 will be 14 options total available. Next, we come to the question number 20. The slice of pizza. Here, there is one round pizza and there is one square pizza. The round pizza has a diameter of 30. So that means the radius is 15. Right? So first let us find the complete area of the pizza. Total area will be pi r square. So comes out to be this. Now it is divided in 10 pieces. So I will divide it by 10 and the answer comes out to be 70.71, which is approximately it will be 71. That means one slice of circular pizza is equal to this much. Now, so this is coming out to be the area of one slice of circular pizza, area of one piece. Now when we come to the square, the side is given to be 30. So this square has a side of 30. So you know area of square is side square. So we'll find first the area of square. This comes out to be 900. So area of one piece will be 900 divided by 12, because the square pizza is cut into 12 pieces. This comes out to be 75. So one slice of square pizza is having more area than one slice of the circular pizza. So we will find the difference. It comes out to be approximately 4 centimeters square. So answer will be part A, that is Sanjana. Approximately 4 centimeters square has bought the better deal and the quantity will be approximately 4. So that's all. Thank you.